Okay, hello everybody, and welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition, where I'm actually gonna go do the tactician's thingy really quick. Oh, I also gotta talk to Blackwall. He's over there. Oh, hey. Nice. I think, do you get like one that's like cheap or something, and then yeah, then after that it's all cost monies. Costs a pretty expensive amount of monies. Accessories, let's try that. I haven't put any accessories on. I do want a grenade belt. I'll put a life ward amulet on. Let's go do the points. Okay. Wait, first, I definitely want sneak. And I want that one. And I want that one. Boop, boop. I should probably get something else. Jeez, yeah, that was actually not a good idea. Oopsie. Really? I only have that many? Oh, dang it, that wasn't a good idea. Okay. Okay, I mean, I guess that's kind of what I had last time, but still. Okay, and I need to give myself a bow. Oh, what? Level 7. Dang it. Okay, well, let's try that out. Bye! Well, hey! Yay! Should I craft some of those scout legs? Stagger, melee defense, stagger, plus 40 maximum. Well, give me that. Dexterity, not really sure what would be helpful or not, but I guess I'll use one that I have the most of. Okay. Sure. Vigorous Shrewd Scout Legs. Cool, cool. And now I need to go put them on.
Good.
Modify my armor. Let me have it. Let me have it. No, I want modify armor. Okay. That's what I'm wearing, right? Sweet. Okay. Sweet. Look at me with my bow! Oh, it looks so awesome! Bow is cool, bow is cool, bow is cool. Hello.
Yeah. Make her look at it. So much easier to ignore when it's far away. And to actually walk out of it, to be that close.
You could get closer.
It's right there. We could take a trip, if you're that curious.
I'm gonna have to decline. At least until I learn more about it. I have to admit, I thought you'd be
human.
Not elf.
Yes.
Yeah.
Being up front is better than knife ear.
It was a foolish thought.
Ah, he
proves. Should have better than to say anything. It's what you do and how you do it that's important. Just one question then. How do you think you fit in with all this?
Not sure yet.
It's been a whirlwind. It's hard to say where I fit.
I guess we'll have to figure that out.
Indeed.
For me, I'll be satisfied so long as we find the bastards that killed the Divine.
Indeed, Blackwall. Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
I've heard rumors of abandoned warden camps all over these parts.
Right, he gives you a quest.
If we have time, I'd like to take a look. See if there's anything we can salvage.
Okie dokie. Let's chat.
I want to hear more about you.
Compared to yours, my life will seem dull indeed.
No, no!
Your name, Blackwall, doesn't sound Orlesian. Marcher, then? Ferelden?
I was from the Free Marchers originally. Markham. That was a long time ago. Another life.
Indeed.
I hear that many wardens were once criminals.
You're right. And when you join, your past is forgotten, so let's leave it that way.
Yep.
What did you do before you became a warden?
I was a soldier, a nobody trained to wield a sword and follow orders. I grew weary of fighting other men's wars.
So you became a warden?
More or less.
Becoming more or less. Warden, nice. Nice.
Like I mattered. The life I led before seems hollow in comparison. Perhaps one day it will fade away.
That was the hope, wasn't it? I think he doesn't fade away so much as he learns to overcome it.
Why did you join the Wardens?
Because they remember honor and sacrifice. Words that have little meaning to the rest of us. Because they lay down their lives for those they have sworn to protect. We all need to believe there are such men in the world. I needed to believe I could be one of them.
Ugh. You are Blackwall!
We'll continue this discussion at another time.
Very well.
You have done things that no man should,
service.
But...
Let's talk about the Grey Wardens. You must know a lot about them.
But you've also done things no man would.
Wardens? I'm afraid we're less exciting than we seem.
See, people who are kind of on... who knew a lot about the Wardens kind of got the hints, I think, early on that Blackwall wasn't what he said he was exactly. Wasn't on the up and up anyway.
The Blight's been over for 10 years. What do Wardens do when the world's not ending?
There are still Darkspawn. Just because we killed so many in Ferelden doesn't mean they're gone. And the world is not so peaceful that there's no use for good men with swords. Sometimes you have to figure out for yourself what the pledge to protect others really means.
Indeed.
It's not always about just archdemons and Blights.
I remember the mage lady in Origin says that it's not just about protecting others, it's about being in service to the people. Like, you do not lord over them. They don't serve you, you serve them, type thing.
Where were you during the Blight?
I was in Ferelden, on my own, like always. Quietly killed my fair share of Darkspawn, too.
Yeah, if he'd have been in Ferelden at the time, and he was, you know, actually a Grey Warden, he could have helped out Alistair and the hero of Ferelden.
You haven't had contact with other Wardens for a while. Why were you on your own?
It's what I've always done. Recruitment only requires one man. Besides, I've always been a loner. Works best for everyone that way.
You're so adorable.
So you have no idea where the rest of the Wardens are?
Do you find that odd? The Blight is over. We don't need an organized force. And orders don't change much from day to day.
He does seem to know...
The last 1,000 years or so, it's been just find Darkspawn, kill them, repeat as necessary.
Yeah, I think he knew enough that he's able to pass as a Grey Warden. He's
Let's
passed really well.
Let's continue this another time.
As you wish. I'll be here if you need me.
I don't know. Oh, I like the look of the bow and arrow. I really do. Let's get that off my face. And that one takes ages to do. Like, you're like, oh, I'll just go check it off down the list. Nope, it takes ages.
Greetings.
We've already talked, right?
I have some more questions.
Why am I not surprised?
We've already talked
about
this.
Sweet aunt. It was, what, 18?
Maybe not. I can't remember.
Ago.
Sorry.
Some still discuss it like it happened yesterday. The tale gets bigger each time it's told. I barely
Pretty
recognize
sure.
myself within it now.
That's what happens with stories that become legends.
I am not a legend, nor was I then.
You
I
are
was
a legend.
Barely out of training. To hear others tell it, I alone saved Divine Beatrix from a horde of dragons sent to assault the Grand Cathedral. Rather impressive for such a young seeker, wouldn't you say?
And the truth is?
I stumbled upon a conspiracy to kill Beatrix. A Templar Knight Commander was at its heart. And there was a dragon battle at the Grand Cathedral, but I had help from loyal mages who rallied to the cause. They freed the dragons from magical control. Without them, the Divine and I would both have died.
I wonder, is it like her own story?
The right hand, and they are forgotten.
Like in a book?
What happened to the mages that helped you?
They went back to their circles, with rewards and privileges and most holy gratitude. Many of them died at the conclave.
An impressive tale. I can see why people enjoy telling it.
Just wait till they start telling stories about you.
Teehee! And she won't tell us about her brother yet. Pretty sure. We'll go stop in with Cullen.
Did you need something?
Are you with it? Did I already react to that?
I'd like to know more about the Templars. If you need insight into what the Order is doing now, I'm afraid I can't offer more than you already.
I swear we've already done this, but maybe
anything
not.
Anything else, I will answer as best I can.
Oh my gosh!
Why did you join the Order?
I could think of no better calling than to protect those in need. I used to beg the Templars at our local chantry to teach me. At first, they merely humored me. I must have shown promise, or at least a willingness to learn. The Knight Captain spoke to my parents on my behalf. They agreed to send me for training. I was 13 when I left home.
13? That's still so young.
I wasn't the youngest there. Some children are promised to the Order at infancy.
I wonder
still,
why he just, like...
I didn't
like...
take on full responsibilities until I was 18. The Order sees you trained and educated first.
It's not like he was, like, brought into it. He, like, chose the life for himself.
What about your family? Did you miss them?
Of course. But there were many my age who felt the same. We learned to look out for one another.
Do the Templars do anything besides hunt mages?
Templars protect against the dangers of magic. Before the Order left the Chantry, that meant serving in a circle. They were also tasked with tracking apostates or fighting demons inevitably summoned by the weak or malicious.
What do you think of mages? Are they all a threat?
I've seen the suffering magic can inflict.
Yes,
I've
he has.
I've treated mages with distrust because of it, at times without cause. That was unworthy of me. I will try not to do so here. Not that I want mages moving through our base completely unchecked. We need safeguards in place to protect people, including mages, from possession of the beast.
Interesting that, like, having played Origins as a mage, as a female mage, it's just interesting that, like, yeah, like, he started out as, like, so happy and, like, just this innocent type guy, but then he goes through something so horrible that would have killed anybody else, would have destroyed anybody else, but he's still here.
What was a typical day for a Templar there?
Typical? The last time I was in a circle was right before it fell apart. Nothing was typical.
Before that day?
Certain rituals require a full guard. A mage's harrowing.
He attended my harrowing.
I've attended a few. Most of the time, you merely maintain a presence.
He was gonna...
control or in the circle. Ready to respond if needed.
He was gonna have to kill me if I failed.
But they're watching you just as closely.
The Templars and mages never speak to each other.
Some do. But Templars are supposed to maintain a certain distance from
supposed to!
If a mage is possessed or uses blood magic, you must act quickly, without hesitation. Your judgment cannot be clouded. Of course, ignoring one another does nothing to foster understanding.
Yeah.
What does Templar training involve?
There is weapon and combat training. Even without their abilities, Templars are among the best warriors in Thedas. Initiates must also memorize portions of the Chant of Light, study history, and improve their mental focus.
Did you enjoy your training?
I wanted to learn everything. If I was giving my life to this, I would be the best Templar I could.
He had that
student.
He had that zeal.
I wanted to be. I wasn't always successful. Watching a candle burn down while reciting the Chant of Transfiguration wasn't the most exciting task. I admit, my mind sometimes wandered.
Yeah, to the pretty elven mage that you fell in love with.
The Templars take vows. I swear to the Maker to watch all the mages. That's
the vigil first. You're meant to be at peace during that time, but your life is about to change. When it's over, you give yourself to a life of service. That's when you're given a filter, your first draft of Lyria and its power. As Templars, we are not to seek wealth or acknowledgement. Our lives belong to the Maker and the path we have chosen.
That's all I wanted to know. Thank you.
Should you require anything, I'll be here.
All right, hang on.
Was there something you needed?
Are you with anyone? No. No, wait, just hold your horses, Talon.
Why would Templars break away from the Chantry?
The Order believes the Chantry no longer supports their efforts. Not to the extent they should.
But the Templars have served the Chantry for ages.
And in that time, they've come to take the Order's services for granted. Templars risk their lives against blood magic, demons, abominations, to feel as if those efforts are dismissed.
Yeah.
I may disagree with the Order's actions, but I'm here as proof of that. But I sympathize with their frustrations.
Indeed. It does. It makes sense. I mean, after so long, it's... But still, like, there had to have been something. People were paying attention to, like, the mages being irate, but they have not really... They trusted the Templars too much, and they didn't pay attention to the fact that the Templars might be irate.
Is there anything I should know?
The Lord Seeker's actions are a mystery, but the Templars will aid us. They cannot sit idle while the breach remains.
That was something I didn't really get.
Another time, then.
Because I was like, no, they are... They might not, actually, you know? Like... Who knows what they're gonna do?
What can I do for you?
Tell me about the charges.
Let me talk about the bull's charges.
Best company you'll find from here to the Anderfells. In my time with the chief, we've gone up against everything from bandits to magic trees. We're expensive, but you'll never doubt we're worth it. Want to know anything in particular?
Abilities.
Do the charges specialize in anything from a tactical standpoint?
Bull doesn't want us large enough to work as an army. We're better as shock troops or skirmishers. We've got archers for hitting enemy infantry, Dalish with more archery! And her people on the flanks. Rocky handles fortifications and traps, and Stitches keeps us all fighting. They mostly hold back. I'll lead the frontline fighters with Grimm, and the chief goes wherever he can hit something.
Are there rules for how mercenaries operate?
If you don't want some noble to treat you like bandits,
I love Grimm!
There's also a code of conduct most companies hold to. Keeps things civilized on the battlefield. We accept surrenders for ransom from mercenaries, nobles, and soldiers wearing a lord's colors. Our prisoners are treated well, injuries tended. We'd want the same for any of ours who got captured.
I want a romance, Krem!
You said something about everything from bandits to magic trees. I'll admit to some curiosity.
Right. Sylvans. That's what Dalish
called. I found Sylvans in Origins!
There's trees, too. Some noble in the Dales, and they really don't like it when you call them Dalish. Forest. His family had abandoned the land, but he wanted it back. The chief bought us all axes, and in we went. Between the axes and the torches, the Sylvans weren't too bad. Worst part was the squirrels.
Squirrels. At first, it felt really bad. I was like, why are you killing spirit trees? But then in Origins, basically, what happens is sometimes when a spirit gets into a tree, and it's in, like, a battlefield or something, like, a lot of death has happened and the veil is thin, spirits will sometimes get sucked into a tree or get stuck in one, and then they go crazy because they don't understand, like, they don't have the same senses that they're kind of used to. There's no sight or anything, like not what they're used to anyway, you know, and so they actually end up going crazy in there, and so a lot of Sylvans are actually aggressive. But I did meet a really cool one. Let's talk about Iron Bull while he's right here. Oh, wait, I can't talk to Krem again, I don't think.
They've got good form. Cullen's putting his Templar training to good use.
Did Cullen tell you he was a Templar? He's not wearing the armor.
He didn't have to. Might not be a Templar shield, but it's a Templar holding it. He angles the shield just a bit down. Helps direct fire or acid away, so it doesn't spray right into your face. Kalari learned the same thing.
Why doesn't everybody do that, you know?
To mages.
I guess it's only for fighting mages.
You sound like you want to head down there and give the troops some pointers.
Nah. I'm no good at command unless I know who my guys are sleeping with and what they like to drink. Inquisition's already too large for that.
Nice!
The charges are big enough for me. Biggest problem for the Inquisition right now isn't on the front line. It's at the top. You've got no leader. No Inquisitor.
I always consider Cassandra the leader.
Cassandra's been the driving force of this Inquisition. She's the leader in all but name.
Cassandra's a seeker. From what I gather, that's a bit like a Ben Hasrath. She's a good hunter and a great fighter, but she doesn't see the big picture. Too busy searching for answers. My people don't pick leaders from the strongest, or the smartest, or even the most talented. We pick the ones willing to make the hard decisions, and live with the consequences. Ah, who knows? Maybe you seal the breach. The Chantry gets off its ass and all those soldiers go home and get that.
You think?
Wouldn't that be
it
nice?
It won't. But it could.
Yeah.
Can I help you?
Why the name?
Iron Bull?
I picked it. We don't have names under the cube. Just, I don't know. Job descriptions, I guess.
Yeah.
When I came to Orlais, I chose the Iron Bull for myself.
Why specifically Iron Bull?
This may surprise you, but I really like hitting things. Also, it's the Iron Bull, technically. I like having an article at the front. It makes it sound like I'm not even a person, just a mindless weapon. An implement of destruction. That really works for me.
He is so interesting.
I'd like to know more about your work with the Ben Hasrath.
Ben Hasrath is actually a general term. You've got the secret police who investigate problems inside our territory. You've got the re-educators who take people with problems and fix their minds. Or make them disappear.
Wah.
And then you've got the spies.
I am so tiny
How
compared to him.
How do the re-educators work?
Well, I only know the basics. Wasn't my area. That said, keep a man awake long enough, ask the right questions, give the right potions, and you can get him to say anything. You don't need blood magic or demons to change someone's mind. We're a lot more fragile than we'd like to believe.
You can alter someone's beliefs that easily.
One of my friends was a re-educator. He said that every memory is like the page of a book. When you examine a memory, you're turning to that page, and when you're there, the page is laid bare. Write a few notes in the margins of the page, erase a word here and there, and your whole outlook changes. I always felt a little weird reading after that conversation.
I don't know. I've never done that one, so.
Horrible.
Yeah, they probably do. Here's the thing, though. What happens in Orlais when you commit a crime or betray a lord? They just lop your head off. At least the Canari try to fix you.
None of those sound exactly like you.
Yeah, I was a special case. They sent me to Sahelin
nice.
Because they needed someone who could fight and hunt down problems. That whole island was a sack of cats. Incursions from Taventa, Talvashath, and native rebels fighting both sides. And in the middle, me, trying to wrangle the rebels and restore order.
Can't imagine that was easy.
Nope. I hunted down a lot of rebels. Lost a lot of friends to the Vince, or the Fog Warriors, or the Talvashath. One day I woke up and couldn't think of a damned reason to keep doing my job. Turned myself into the re-educators.
I've never
Not
done
many
that
people
one.
Would have the courage to do that.
I thought about letting some rebel kill me. I couldn't give any of those bastards the satisfaction. The Ben Hasrath ordered me to go to Orlais, ostensibly as a Talvashath, and work undercover.
So he's been
That's
re-educated,
how I ended
like.
Up here.
It's kind of something interesting, you know? Aw, cute.
That's a. Damn.
You did ask. Anyway, nice talking with you.
Yep. Yeah. Cool. Let's keep
you?
Talking.
I'd like to know more about the Kunari.
You writing a book?
What I've heard about them sounds fascinating.
What you've heard was mostly horse shit. All right.
Yeah.
What do you want to know?
What's it like growing up under the Kune?
The Tamasrans raise us in these units.
Talking takes a long time.
Age. They're like teachers or chantry sisters. They also help figure out what jobs we should do. They had me pegged for military work early on. When they learned I could
Big
hit
boy.
Stuff and lie, they started training me for the Ben Hasra.
They don't like say, no, don't do that. They say, oh, you can lie? Here, let's use that ability.
It must have been a good day for you.
Yes. It's like being a block of stone with a sculptor working on you. One day, the last of the crap gets knocked off, and you can see your real shape. What you're supposed to be. That's a good day.
Hmm.
How do the Kunari rule themselves?
It's pretty simple.
That's kind of a nice way to look at it, I guess, you know?
The priesthood and the military. The priesthood figures out how Kunari should live in theory. The matriarchy makes it work in practice. And the military keeps the Kunari safe from outside threats.
Does it actually work like that? Is there much infighting?
Not like you're thinking of. People disagree, yeah, but the priests are there to solve disagreements.
I have a hard time seeing this system working.
People putting their own gain ahead of the gains of society. If you do that among the Kunari, the Bin Hasrath set you straight or kill you.
I just have a hard... Yeah, in theory that's nice, but I have a really hard time seeing that actually working out. You know, like, by nature, people are selfish, not in a bad way, it's just... But, I don't know, like, I guess if you were trained from a young age, you might...
How is everyday life different for Kunari?
Be used to it.
Depends on your job, I guess. Some are just about the same. A baker in Val Royale gets up, gets dressed, and starts work. A baker in Parvolin does the same thing. They don't care about the Empire or the Cume. Mostly they worry about breaking eggs and hope the dough rises right.
It can't be exactly the same. The Kunari have no personal freedoms.
How many?
Well, I think they do within a limit, you know?
The baker in Val Royale has. Life isn't about freedom. The baker in Parvolin wonders if she'll be given enough eggs to do her work. Will they come on time? Will the kitchen workers get her bread while it's fresh, or will they come late and blame her because it's stale?
It's just living,
same
you know?
Same crap in Val Royale. People are just people.
I think they just, it's a little bit more immediate, but like at the same time, it's like if you're put into your job and it's what you're good at, it's what you want to do. I don't think there's a whole lot of people who are necessarily like, yeah, let me rebel because they're happy with what they have. And they have the freedom, like, they're not like, it's not like every single move is dictated. Like, the baker knows how to bake because she was taught how to bake, but she can kind of mess with it if she wants, you know? Like, it's not like they're in their house watching you 24/7. I mean, I think that's kind of the feeling they're supposed to give, but it's not necessarily what it is. But, I mean, the baker in Val Royale wakes up and, you know, has to, I don't know, worry about the politics of the day, trying to screw her over or something, you know? At least... people in Parvolin don't have to worry about that, but at the same time, it's like life isn't about freedom. It makes me go, ugh! You know, like, I don't know, as like a modern person, probably as an American too, it's just, you know, you grow up with like, you know, freedom, yeah, woo, but it, I mean, it's the same thing, kind of, it's just, you know, it's similar for most people, I think, is that, you know, it's like, what? But then it's like, you think about it, and it's like, well... it's not necessarily what life is all about. You know, it's like some people say, well, life isn't just about surviving. Life isn't just about gaining material wealth. Like, it's a whole... it's, life is a bunch of things. It's bits and pieces of everything, you know?
I heard there's no marriage among the Kunari.
Yeah, that's true. Kunari love our friends like anyone does, but we don't have sex with them.
Kunari don't,
have sex with just regular Kunari?
Oh, we definitely have sex. They're Tamasrins who pop your cork whenever you... yes. It's not a big deal like it is here. It's like, I don't know, going to see a healer. Sometimes it's this long, involved thing. It takes all day, leaves you walking funny. Nah. Other times, you're in and out in 5 minutes. Thank you. See you next week.
That's so funny.
Sometimes I think I understand how different the Kunari are. And then I talk to you.
Yep. Still, it's more fun here. Fewer rituals, more making it up as you go along. Plus, you folk have redheads. Redheads.
I wonder if he would notice if you, became,
or
if like your character was a redhead, you know?
Conquered Orlais or Ferelden.
Some folks, like Cassandra or Cullen, would do fine if they didn't die fighting. Those two love rules. But the mages. Can you imagine Solas trying his fade dreaming under the cube? Or Vivian doing her political bullshit. Both Sarah and Varric would mouth off until they ended up re-educated, drugged until their minds broke. So, to answer your question, no, I don't think about it much at all.
Like, I think they technically, they, like, the Kunari are supposed to be like, yes, bring our way of life to everybody, but I think Bull, living here, realizes you know, he knows that's supposed to kind of technically be the overall goal, but at the same time, it's like, it's just not a way of life for some people.
Is that the race or the religion?
Both. Kind of. The humans and elves who follow the Kune are the Vidathari. The Kanari who break away from the Kune are Talvasha, deserters.
What about Kunari who existed before the Kune?
The people we came from. They're called the Kossuth, but we don't use that word for the race. We came south to Thedas because the Kossuth were... I don't know. We had to leave. The stories aren't clear. But I don't expect they look much like us. Whatever they are.
See you later, boy.
See ya.
That's interesting. I don't, like... I think he mentions later that maybe, like, the Kunari were bred. Or... Sure... by the Kossuth. I'm gonna go do the watchtower thing right now really quick, and then I'll come back and I'll run through this area and talk to everybody again. Quick!
They've got a healer of their own.
This is a funny conversation.
Got a demon claw wound to stop festering faster than I'd ever seen.
I've heard good things about the charges. Polite and respectful.
Never know when you might need your guts shoved back in.
I don't know if this pterodactyl is better than that. If it cannot, then it is
an idiot. It's like, try to say this. She's got a core of steel like Leliana does. Leliana is like steel on the outside, but she's very compassionate on the inside. Let's see. Build watchtowers.
Saying something
about... Wow, it takes a long time. Jeez.
Colin?
Yes. Haven has limited space for our soldiers to train. Perhaps we...
Alamari. Okay. Oh! We can't do... That's the Fallow Mire. I thought we could go there. I guess not. I guess the only place we can go is the Storm Coast and the Hinterlands. Yeah, let's do this. I want to do it.
At your service.
Yes. We gotta pick this up. Oh, okay. Clerics hiring thugs. Oh my gosh. Wow, okay. Did that happen last time? I don't remember. That's really good. Oh, I can't do the Grey Wardens thingy. Okay, we could try it this way. I don't know. Like, Josephine would be the best one for it, but... I don't know. I don't want to use Leliana on that one. I'd rather use Cullen or Josephine. I think Josephine's the one who can use the treaties. And other than that, it looks like we've done everything we can. Okay, good to know. I will continue talking with everybody. Let's go. Then I gotta get back to the grindstone. Ugh, I just want to go get the Templars, because then I have to do what is probably going to be a really long thing, and then I gotta go get Dorian. Dorian! I did fight some things, so maybe I can drop off stuff.
That will help.
Yay! Ram horns. Nice. I don't really talk to Josephine much. I feel kind of bad, but Hello? You wanna talk?
Yes.
I'd like to know more about you, Madame Vivienne.
Whatever would you like to know?
Oh, you two would be cute together. Dang it, too bad she's taken.
Your accent's not Orlesian. Where exactly are you from?
I am from the Circle, my dear. One's country of origin rarely matters there. But if you must know, I was born in Wycombe in the Free Marches. I was sent to the Ostwick Circle, but I transferred to Montsumar while still an apprentice.
I'm curious how a Circle mage winds up a courtier.
Nobody winds up at court, my dear. It takes a great deal of effort to arrive there. I caught the eye of Duke Bastien de Gisline. An advantageous connection that opened many doors.
The way she says his name makes me know that she's not interested.
Vacant, I was able to secure it.
Interested in anybody else, you know?
You're married to the Duke de Gisline.
Of course not, my dear. Don't be ridiculous. Marriage is the business of alliance and inheritance. I'm Bastien's mistress.
So he actually loves you.
What duties does a court enchanter have?
I am tasked with providing assistance to the Empress on arcane matters. Most of my predecessors restricted this to lighting lamps and doing parlor tricks. In such troubled times,
maybe I'll bring her to the ball this time.
I provide political advice to Her Majesty on the subject of the Mage Rebellion.
Okay. See how Liliana's doing really quick.
It seems Blackwald knows nothing about the disappearance of the Grey Wardens. It's a disappointment. I am, however, glad that he is with us, even if he was not what I expected. He seems
what
to
do
be
you
a
mean?
Good man, and his experience will be an asset to the Inquisition. As for the other Wardens, I suppose we will have to keep looking.
Anything I should know?
I have nothing to report at the moment.
I'll leave you to your
okay. Like, I just keep trying to think, I'm not the Inquisitor yet, so any conversations we have is just me being an interested party, being like, yes, I'm the one who's out in the field. Please give me updates and stuff, you know what I mean? So, this?
As I explored the Fade, I felt the presence of an intriguing artifact in the Hinterlands. If you are willing, I would like to locate it. I have marked its location as best I could determine.
Okay.
What do you know about the Fae? A great deal, from my wanderings. There are a few hard facts, but I can share what I have learned.
Yes, do. Tell me about the Veil.
I'd like to know more about the Veil. Circle mages call it a barrier between this world and the Fae. But according to my studies in ancient Elven lore, that is a vast oversimplification. Imagine if spirits entered freely. The Fade was not a place one went, but a state of nature like the wind. Sounds like it would be wonderful. And dangerous. But yes, a world where imagination defines reality. Where spirits are as common as trees or grass. Instead, spirits are strange and fearful. And the Fade is a terrifying world touched only by mages and dreams.
I'm like getting teary-eyed just hearing him talk.
World, along with the obvious peril.
Oh my gosh. It's gonna be really hard to not actively seek out his approval in this game.
I'd like to know more about the breach. Simply put, it is a tear in the veil between this world and the Fade, allowing spirits to enter the world physically. Small tears occur naturally when magic weakens the veil, or when spirits cluster at an area that has seen many deaths. But your mark allows you to exert some control over the That means it was created deliberately. I'd like to know more about demons. The Chantry says that demons hate the natural world and seek to bring their chaos and destruction to the living. But such simplistic labels misconstrue their motivations, and in so doing, do all a great disservice. Spirits wish to join the living. And a demon?
Look at my manly standing. Look at me. I'm so manly. When Erica stands, she stands in that dancer pose.
Is there a way to coexist? To live with them? If not in peace, at least without such active confrontation. Not in the world we know today.
Well, people do it, you know.
The veil creates a barrier that makes true understanding most unlikely. But the question is a good one, and it matters that you thought to ask.
We'll talk later. Goodbye.
Travel to the hinterlands. I think you had something else, didn't you?
I'd be interested in hearing your opinions on elven culture.
I thought you would be more interested in sharing your opinions of elven culture. You are Dalish, are you not?
Proudly.
Yes, I am. The Dalish are the best hope for preserving the culture of our people.
Our people. You use that phrase so casually. It should mean more. But the Dalish have forgotten that, among other things.
Oh, but you know the truth, right?
While they pass on stories, mangling details, I walk the fade. I have seen things they have not.
We are trying.
Irabelas, Harren. If the Dalish have done you a disservice, I would make that right. What course would you set for them that is better than what they know now?
You are right, of course. The fault is mine, for expecting what the Dalish could never truly accomplish. Irabelas, darling. If I can offer any understanding, you have but to ask.
See, I did the proudly thing because I knew you wouldn't like that, and he did it was a disapproval. Like, straight-up disapproval, but at the same time, it's like, I'm not ashamed to be Dalish. Talon is very proud to be Dalish. But he also, like, he's a reasonable dude. He's like, hey, you know, I am proud to be Dalish, but if something has gone wrong, I would change that. And I feel like that question, or that sentence is phrased, like, what course would you set for them that they, you know, that they would do better on. I feel like that was phrased really, really well. I know a lot of the, I don't know if it's just Solas, I think it might also be just throughout the game, but it's based on like the language is rhythmic. And I know Solas a lot actually speaks very rhythmically. I don't think it's iambic pentameter, but I'm not sure. But he speaks in some cases speaks with a set rhythmic speech pattern, which is really nice. It's really cool. It's easy to notice. In some cases, this doesn't happen all the time, but.
Is elven magic different from the magic used by humans?
No, and yes. Magic is magic, just as water is water, but it can be used in different ways. Dalish magic is more practical, not needing chantry approval. Although they still frown on blood magic. Superstition. Much of it is more subtle. A legacy from when elves were immortal.
Legends of elven immortality. Did they use magic to increase their lifespan?
No. It was simply part of being elven. The subtle beauty of their magic was the effect, not the cause of their nature. Some spells took years to cast. Echoes would linger for centuries, harmonizing with new magic in an unending symphony. It must have been beautiful.
You said that blood magic was a superstition.
Just the way he talks about it.
It's fortunate Cassandra is not within earshot. Most modern cultures forbid blood magic. Publicly, even Devinda disapproves of it. But as I said, magic is magic. It matters only in how it is used.
To be honest, I don't see it as different from any other magic. It's a means to an end.
Indeed.
Yeah.
The problem is that under the chantry, blood magic is forbidden, so only criminals practice it. Magisters compete with each other instead of keeping their volatile friends in check. They always succeed through power, so they have never had the chance to learn another way.
Kind of, actually. I don't know, this might be kind of controversial, but it kind of reminds me of, war on drugs or whatever. If you keep pounding, making drugs, like stuff like marijuana. It's like making that illegal just means that the people who use it are treated as criminals, and then they kind of think of themselves as criminals and become criminals, and you know, and instead of, you know, and then the drug lords get tons of money from competing with each other instead of it just being like a sanctioned, you know, governmental sanctioned and watched process.
I'd like to know more about the elves from before our time.
The Dalish strive to remember Halam Shiral. But Halam Shiral was merely a fumbling attempt to recreate a forgotten land.
Arlathan.
Elvanan was the empire. And Arlathan, its greatest city.
Elvanan.
Place of magic and beauty, lost to time.
You studied ancient elves. What else do you know of Olathan?
We hear stories of them living in trees, and imagine wooden ramps or Dalish aerovels. Imagine instead spires of crystal twining through the branches, palaces floating among the clouds. Imagine beings who lived forever, for whom magic was as natural as breathing. That is what was lost.
So you get a little bit of a rhythmic speech pattern there.
Are all Dalish elves like my clan?
No. Your clan was unique in having enough interest in human affairs to send you to spy upon the Divine's meeting. As your clans have been separate for so long, they have all changed.
Don't they have that, like, 10-year meeting, though?
Some are no more than bandits. Others trade freely with humans. And some have disappeared entirely into the forests.
So, like, I feel like the ancient elves were, like, really civilized, right? They, like, lived in, like, really fancy cities and stuff. But the Dalish are wandering, like, perhaps the old elves did. Like, just, like, living in the woods and stuff,
you know?
What can
you tell me about elves living in human cities?
The culture in alienages or among the slaves of Tevinter is like any of the impoverished and powerless. They cling to memories of a better past and practice a few rituals to distinguish themselves from humans.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. I feel like Talon would greatly respect Solas, though. Like, so, you know, there's going to be probably a lot of approval. Also, it's habit for me. I can't not.
Something like that.
Have I not talked to you?
Chasing mages. That's a Templar's job. A big, armored, pissed-off helm polisher. Not too late to go find some. Or stay home.
So, do you want to do the whole thing? Or we get Templars?
What about me?
What? Oh, god, no. Okay,
we'll
I already did
later.
That.
If you say so.
So we did already talk to Sarah.
Your wish is something, something.
Something, something.
What do you think about the people who have gathered?
Which, the ones who do things or the ones who give orders?
Nice. Let's see. We just got Vivian and Iron Bull and Blackwall.
She's a bitch, but she knows.
Ooh!
She better.
She's the kind of person that she would...
Iron Bull?
Trick.
He makes me wonder about things. I mean, what women look like? Woof.
What?
Any thoughts about Warden Blackwall?
He's too good, right? I'd like to see him out of that uniform. Not like that.
With Erica, her and Blackwall and Sarah got along really, really well. I took them out a lot, and they got along really well.
We'll talk later.
Good, right? I'll be here.
It was really fun. Whoa! This is the song, I think.
Is there any way
I think
you
this song is supposed to be about Solas.
Six,
when I listen to it, actually, I listen to it a lot.
I was really hoping you only needed six.
When I was listening to it a long time ago, or not a long time ago, but recently, I guess, reminded me of Solas, and I think I saw something online actually that said it is supposed to be sort of a song about Solas. Just because it reminded me of him, because it's like the eternal watcher in a way, I don't know. Like the one who, because he talks to Blackwall at one point and says, you know, I will remember all of this, you know, like everything everybody's doing, the good, the battles, the small things, I'll remember all of it.
Can I ask you something, Varric?
You want to talk about me? I'm flattered.
Uh-huh.
Also,
okay, we haven't talked to you yet.
How do you and Cassandra know each other?
You heard about the Kirkwall Chantry being destroyed? The guy responsible used to be a friend of mine.
Did he? Oh, God.
I had questions about that, and I had answers.
You from Ferelden? Olay?
Free marches. Born and raised in Kirkwall. And despite whatever you've heard, no, Kirkwall's not that bad.
Nah.
I'm not clear on your line of work. You're a merchant.
I'm a businessman. My family has a seat in the Dwarven Merchants Guild. Merchants buy and sell goods. Businessmen buy and sell stores. In my spare time, I manage a spy network, and occasionally, I write books.
If you've run a spy network, why is Leliana our spy mom?
Because she's like pro.
With you, she's just a better spy master. The truly great ones can keep their distance. They don't get attached to their people. me, I always wind up babysitting my informants and worrying about their families. We're in better hands with her.
He has a smaller network, you know. Helps him kind of like Bull and the Chargers, like keeps track of everybody a little bit easier.
You're an author. What kind of books have you written?
I've tried my hands at a few genres.
Indeed you have.
My most popular, Hard in Hightown.
I still have to read those.
To get things done. The Tale of the Champion is the most famous thing I've written, or infamous, maybe. I started a romance serial once, Swords and Shields, but to be honest, I don't have a knack for romances. Most of my stories end in tragedy. Probably that says something unfortunate about me personally.
I like Varric.
Actually, we don't own shops. That was just an example. Mostly we invest in moneylenders. Auction houses, a few mercenary companies, a couple of smithies. I think we own half a beet plantation in Ravain somewhere. Most of that's my brother's doing. Bartrand had business sense. Not much tact, but loads of business sense.
Where did you get that crossbow? I've never
seen
one.
I want it.
Bianca, she's one of a kind. Funny story. I bought a salvaged ship and found her locked in a dragonbone reinforced chest in the hold. I broke 3 dozen lockpicks and blunted 9 saws opening that trunk, but it was worth it.
Really?
I can't tell you.
Why?
And the reason for that is
complicated. It's the one story I'll never tell. We just have to leave it at that.
Okay.
Thanks, Varric.
No problem.
Varric and Iron Bull, I think, are one of the only ones that the Inquisitor actually addresses by name, like at the end of conversations. I'm not sure if the male one did it for Iron Bull, but I noticed with the female, she'd say, I'll talk to you later, Bull, or see you later, Varric. And I was always like, why? That's the Mabari story. Was that everybody? Good golly, it took an hour. Varric, Sarah, Liliana, Iron Bull, Cassandra, Cullen, Solas, Vivian, Minav, Josephine. Not Josephine, but her stuff doesn't really change. I know there's a logging stand over there, but I don't want to run all the way over there. Okay, so I'm going to call it at this part. Hopefully in the next one we can get enough of points to have more. We have 10 now. I think it said, yep, and then we can go get the freaking Templars, and then we can get Cole, and then we can, I'm really excited to see Dorian's entrance, because you know Cole made an entrance when you side with the mages. He's like, I've come to warn you, you know, blah, 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 and it's like, I'm excited to see what Dorian's is going to be. It's going to be really dramatic, I'm sure. I'm excited. Anyway, thanks again for joining me, you guys. Next one.